Well, thank you all for coming tonight. We have a kind of small school, so we have a kind of small crowd, but we don't have a small program because they've really put a lot of work into what they're going to do here at the beginning. They've put a lot of work into the school year also, so they've accomplished quite a bit, and hopefully the program will be a blessing to you, and you'll also get a chance to see everything they've accomplished. They've worked hard all year long. We don't just, when you see how many people made the honor roll and how many marking periods they made it, you will be astonished. But they work for it. We don't just hand them out around here. So they've done a really great job. And we have to acknowledge the staff, so because they don't get a chance to be acknowledged very often. I'm pretty bad at thanking people. So I'm going to thank them tonight. So Mrs. Crater is our kindergarten teacher, and she also does first and second grade science, and she does PE, to which we all say, yes, because there's a lot of us who don't want to do PE, but she does faithfully does PE. Next year, she's not really sure what she's doing because we don't have a kindergartner enrolled yet, but she's going to be here, right, Mrs. Crater? Mrs. Crater will be here. So we appreciate Mrs. Crater. We'll clap for the teacher. And then we have Mrs. Chrisman. Mrs. Chrisman, who claims the distinction of never having done the same thing twice, because each year she has a different combination of classes and a different combination of responsibilities, but she does all of them well. And this year, you liked your schedule this year, right? So she's planning to be back next year. She says she'll stay. So, but we appreciate her, and she's had first through third grade this year. And then that was enough, right? We didn't really need to give you anything else. Okay, very good. And then we had Mrs. York was with us for the first year this year, and I don't know what it says, the fact that she's not coming back, but I understand that there's this distance between here and Lititz that. So if anybody works in like the transportation industry and can work that out for us, that somehow that cars move faster or we can fly them here or something. But we were glad to have her this year. She did a lot. She worked with, she had Lucy, and then she did art, and she worked with spelling with some, and reading and writing. So she did dishes, right? She did lots of dishes. So we appreciate all that she did this year. Did we clap? Clap. And then we have Mrs. Iwaka at the piano. And Mrs. Iwaka was obviously our music teacher. She gives piano lessons, and also she donated her time this year to be our music teacher and to lead this fine little group here in what you're gonna hear tonight. So we appreciate Mrs. Iwaka. And of course, Pastor Chrisman, he's the head honcho and also the PE teacher for the older grades. So we can't forget him. All right, he is going to open us up in prayer tonight, and then the kids will come up and they'll do God's top 10 commandments for you.
All right, it's good to see everybody here. Mrs. Beetle forgot herself. Let's give her a round of applause. Appreciate her and her hard work. Let's pray and ask God's blessing on our time here this evening. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you for the privilege we have to be able to be here tonight. Lord, I thank you for the families that are gathered here, the families of our school. And Lord, I pray that you would bless now in this program, be with these young people, and help them as they sing and present this program to us. And we thank you for your word, which it represents. Lord, I pray that you'd guide and direct in the awards part of this program as well, and the graduation. May your will and way be done in everything that's said and done this evening. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Long ago, God brought his people out of Egypt to Mount Sinai. One morning, the mountain started shaking. There was fire and smoke and thunder and lightning and a loud trumpet. And God met for Moses on top of the mountain and gave the Ten Commandments. God's top 10.
God's top 10 commandments
Commandment number one.
God said, I am the Lord your God. Have no other gods before me.
Commandment number two.
Don't worship idols.
Commandment number three.
Do not take the Lord's name in vain.
God's name is holy. God's
Commandment number 4.
Keep the Sabbath day holy.
Commandment number 5.
Honor your father and your mother.
Commandment number 6, ladies and gentlemen.
Do not murder.
number 7.
Do not commit adultery.
That means?
Be faithful to your husband or wife.
When you grow up big and strong, you'll be ready to set sail out upon the seas of life, and you will never fail. When you find a husband or a wife that God has planned for you, you'll never cheat and serve them well. And remember to be true. Be true to your mate. Be true to your mate. Be true to your mate. Mate. Be true to your mate. If life's a ship we're sailing on, you need your mate to keep you strong. So be true. Be true to your mate. When the storms of life are trying to blow you overboard, don't forget your promise to your mate and to the Lord. God has joined together, let no man tear apart. Remember this little song and sing it from the heart. Be true to your mate, mate. Be true to your mate. Be true to your mate, mate. Be true to your mate. Life's a ship, we're sailing on.
Commandment number 8.
Do not steal.
Bike, rice, kite, friends, sir.
Commandment number 9.
Do not bear false witness.
That means don't lie. Last but not least, commandment number 10.
Do not covet.
Never covet, be above it. Coveting will get the best of you. Remember all that God has given you, you. Greedy Gus sees people starve and really starts to love it. C-O-V-E-T, C-O-V-E-T, C-O-V-E-T. Boy, he loves to covet. When you want another stuff, that's what it means to covet. C-O-V-E-T, C-O-V-E-T, C-O-V-E-T. Boy, he loves to covet. Greedy Gus has got to learn God's 10th commandment.
Don't.
C-O-V-E-T.
Don't.
C-O-V-E-T.
Don't.
C-O-V-E-T. Never, never covet. Never covet. Be above it. Coveting will get the best of you. Never covet. Be above it. Remember all that God has given you. If Gus does not get what he wants, he'll start to scream and cry. Wah, wah.
Thank you.
Okay, we'd like to begin with the presentation of certificates that these boys and girls have earned this year. We're going to start with kindergarten. So, Susanna York, would you come up, please? And I'll let you know what this says. It says, this certificate is awarded to Susanna York for achieving the Distinguished Honor Roll for 2 quarters and High Honor Roll for 2 quarters for the 2012-2013 school year. So that is yours. Congratulations. She has another one. This is for Excellence in Achievement. This certificate is awarded to Susanna York for Excellence in Bible, Phonics, and Numbers during the 2012-2013 school year. And this one is for her character. She's quite a character. But this is awarded because of her creativeness, for exemplary display of creativeness for during the 2012-2013 school year.
I'm going to give out first through third grade, so I'm going to start with my first graders here. And it looks like I'm going to start with Justin Beadle. So Justin, if you'd come up. I've got a couple of awards to give to you, sir. Justin has a certificate for achieving the High Honor Roll for 4 quarters this year, so the whole year long, so sir, that is for you. He also has Excellence in Achievement for Bible, Phonics, Arithmetic, and PE during the 2012-2013 year. And Justin also had perfect attendance this year, so never missed a day, did you, sir? Nope. And Justin's character award this year is Determination. You can just see it on his face. His little face scrunches up, and you know, man, he's going to do it. If it's the last thing he does, it's going to get done. So Justin has showed quite a bit of a determination this year. So that's what I'm going to do. All right, Seth, if you want to come up. And Seth's, yes, this is my son. Seth's first award is for achieving Distinguished Honor Roll for 4 quarters this year. He also has Excellence in Bible, Phonics, Arithmetic, Penmanship, Reading, and Physical Education this year. And like a lot of my students, he also has perfect attendance. And Seth's character award this year is for dependability. If you told Seth, go up to the classroom, or to go up to another classroom and go do this, he'd go do it, he'd come right back. You say, do this paper, he'd sit there and do it. He's just very dependable, very easy to give a task and expect it to get done the right way. So that one's for you. All right, Miss Heidi, you're next. All right, Heidi achieved High Honor Roll for 2 quarters and Honor Roll for 2 quarters this year. And she has Excellent in Achievement for Bible, Phonics, Arithmetic, and PE for the year. And Heidi also gets an award that none of my other students get. And we don't give this one out just because. Heidi gets the award for Most Improved this year. The start of the year were some bumps and stuff along the way, weren't there? But I mean, she just blossomed this year, and by the end of the year, it was just amazing to listen to her read and how expressive she was, how clear sentences were, how much she had gained through the year. So we were very happy to see you improve so well this year. And one more for Miss Heidi, her character award. And we chose unselfishness for you, Heidi. If Heidi came in with some little treat, she usually had 3 and she was usually ready to share it. And just always very willing, oh, after school, well, Mommy, I have extra snacks in my bag. I'll share them with everybody. So she's just always willing to give of herself and of her things. All right, and moving on to second grade for Bethany York. All right, and Bethany achieved Distinguished Honor Roll for 2 quarters and High Honor Roll for 2 quarters for this year. She also had excellence in Bible, arithmetic, phonics, spelling, penmanship, and PE. And Bethany's character award this year, we chose cheerfulness. There's just not, yeah, you can see the smile there. There's just not a more cheerful little girl. She comes into the classroom, she's got a big smile on her face, just always happy and always ready to cheer everybody up. So that one's for me. All right, and third grade, Jordan, we'll take you first. All right, and Jordan achieved Distinguished Honor Roll for 3 quarters and High Honor Roll for 1 quarter this year. And he also had excellence in Bible, arithmetic, language, spelling, history, science, music, and PE. And the character award that we chose for Jordan this year is confidence. And you could tell that in his performance tonight. Not every child would be able and would be willing to have that kind of confidence to get up and do that. And if you want to know an answer, Jordan's got it. I mean, he's very confident, very sure of himself, which is a good thing, and we're happy to see that in him. All right, my other third grader, Lily. And Lily achieved Distinguished Honor Roll for 3 quarters and High Honor Roll for 1 quarter. And she achieved excellence in Bible, arithmetic, reading, language, spelling, history, science, and physical education this year. And Lily also had perfect attendance for the year. And Lily's character award this year we chose was attentiveness. When the teacher started speaking, it was time to listen. And if you had instructions to give, she was ready to stand and listen to all you had to say. The other ones might be walking away, but Lily was ready to listen and to be attentive to what needed to be done. All right, Mrs. Beadle, I'll turn it over to you.
So I always manage to not have the first person tell you what the awards actually mean, and that's my fault. So Distinguished Honor Roll is 4.0, and the High Honor Roll is 3.5 to 3.99, and then the Regular Honor Roll is 3.0 to 3.49. And then if they got what was called excellence in something, that means that they got an A every single marking period. So not just an A average, but they got an A in that course every single marking period. So that's pretty impressive. And then of course, the character awards and perfect attendance, I think that's pretty self-explanatory, right? Okay, so I have, we don't like to call ourselves the leftovers, right? But I have the leftovers, if you're not in first through third year with me. And so I had Rachel in fourth grade, and Daniel in fifth grade, and Brandon in eighth grade, and Daniel Wright was a senior. So Rachel received Distinguished Honor Roll for 2 quarters and High Honor Roll for 2 quarters. And then she got excellence in Bible, arithmetic, reading, penmanship, spelling, history, science, art, and PE. That's a lot of A's. And for Rachel's character award, we chose responsibility. She's pretty much her own teacher. She just goes. Like, you just tell her, okay, the bell rang, start, and she pushes, we have DVDs, and so she pushes play, and that's pretty much it. In the end of the day, she's done with everything she needed to do, and she may have one question every 3 weeks that she needs to ask me. Other than that, she gets it all done, and it's all on time, and so she's responsible. All right, and then we have Daniel York. And Daniel York got the High Honor Roll all 4 marking periods. And he has excellence in Bible, arithmetic, reading, history, science, art, and physical education. And then we really struggled for a character award for Daniel. But it's not what you think. We actually had 3 that we were thinking, you know, he shows these things. And we weren't sure which one was the most prominent in his life. And so what we came up with was politeness. Pastor Chrisman pointed out that in PE, sometimes he'll say, Pastor Chrisman will say, we're going to do this this way, or we're going to do that, and he gets a few who may not like his opinion very well, but Daniel always graciously is, okay, that's fine. And he is very polite to me. He does some ma'ams and things like that, so he's a polite young man. And then we have Brandon Beadle. He's in eighth grade. He keeps reminding me he's going into high school next year. So he is going into high school next year. This year, though, he got high honor roll for four quarters. And he has excellence in Bible, history, computer, music, and physical education. And the character trait that we chose for Brandon is cooperation. So he's very cooperative with us, doesn't give me a whole lot of trouble about anything, just sort of a go-with-the-flow kind of guy most of the time, and we appreciate that. All right. And we're missing Daniel Wright tonight, so we'll give his awards. He has a graduation on Sunday that you're all invited to, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. If you want to come back for another graduation, we have an actual senior high graduation that day. We'll give him his awards then, but he had to be at another graduation tonight. That's why he's not with us.
I'll start by saying, Susanna Grace York was born at a very young age. I've always wanted to use that line. So today she is completing one of many milestones that she'll reach in her life. Susanna is a creative artist, someone who's able to entertain herself during her daily quiet time. She has shown exceptional skill in word matching games. Finally this month, I managed to win a game against her. She is probably the best colorer I have ever had, and maybe having two older sisters and a brother helped her get ready to school for school. So I want to thank Daniel and Bethany and Rachel for that. Numbers are her strength. Number recognition was never an issue. She has no problem counting by tens, fives, or twos, or telling time when the hour, the half, or the quarter. She is also very good at counting coins, and she enjoyed playing store. When it came to science class, I found that Susanna loves animals. I could tell by all of her stuffed animal friends that I met during show and tell. She's also a good gardener. The bean plant that she grew from seed shows a lot of promise. In social studies, she knows the 7 continents and the 4 oceans. I think she must be globally minded. Her handwriting is also very good, and we have to give her mom credit for that. Last year, when Heidi and Justin and Seth were in kindergarten, we acted out the 3 little pigs. You can guess who was the big bad wolf. But Susanna, being the only kindergartner, had me concerned about how the 2 of us were going to pull this off. But never fear. Susanna, with the help of several willing stuffed animals, was the voice for all the characters. Then came Little Red Riding Hood. Again, Susanna provided the voices. There were plays we put on using stick puppets made of paper. And Susanna, the artist, created very recognizable characters. She also memorized several poems. We would often say the poems together. But when she felt confident to say them by herself, up would go the hand. And I knew that that was a signal to me that I should stop, and she would finish it on her own. If she ever decides to be a crossing guard, and she puts up that hand, you can be sure she means stop. Now, in April, we had a special day for students to come dressed as what they would like to be when they grew up. And among other people, we had a writer and we had a preacher. And Susanna chose to come as a mother. Whatever she chooses later, I know she will do well. And I know I will miss her. Okay. Now for the presentation of the kindergarten diploma. Susanna, if you'll come forward. Congratulations, Susanna York, on a job well done. I'll shake your hand this time. And this is for you. Okay, let's all give her a hand.
I've heard all different things about how long I have. Some said 5 minutes, some said 10 minutes. The people who saw the cake said five. I know you all didn't come here to hear me or see me. You came here for the graduation, and that's why I'm here. So I'm going to keep it very, very brief. But I am very, very proud of my daughter, Susanna. We don't have any more kindergartners. We don't have anybody else to come up through the ranks, Mrs. Kreider. I'm so sorry. She had two, and I do want to say before I get started this evening that I am very grateful to Mrs. Pat Kreider. She's been a big influence on our family, and we've really appreciated her ministry to our children. I want to share just a few thoughts with you very quickly from Deuteronomy chapter number 6. They're not things I'm sure you're not familiar with, but I was thinking about the graduation and thinking about the opportunity to be here, and just to say a few things very briefly as it relates to education, because education is important. Deuteronomy chapter number 6, of course, the last book that Moses penned, and some very important instruction that he gave here, and he gives the very great commandment there in verses 4 and 5. He says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might." And of course, the Lord confirmed that commandment in the Gospels. When he was challenged, he said, "The first and great commandment is, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy strength, and with all thy might." And then right behind those words here in the book of Deuteronomy in chapter number 6, he says, "And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children." And I was thinking about kindergarten. I was thinking about education in general and how important education is. And the basis of education, and one of the reasons why we're so thankful for Calvary Christian Academy and for the staff here, for our students being here, and for Susanna, who's had the opportunity to graduate kindergarten here, is this principle of teaching diligently your children. The most important responsibility that parents have is teaching their children. It's not working to provide for their kids. That's important. Yes, that's something that needs to be done. But the most important responsibility that a parent has is to teach and to train their children. One of the things that is sad in our day and age and in our country is that there are many different philosophies relating to education in general. And the unfortunate thing about it is that many people think that education is separate from the family life. That it's X's and O's, it's numbers, it's words, it's science, it's history. But you know, the interesting thing about education is that the whole basis of education is biblical. Education is a biblical thing. God instituted this premise of teaching children. And the primary place for that teaching is in the home. It's the parents' responsibility to instruct and train and teach their children. I feel very sorry for parents and even children today who are forced, for whatever reasons may exist, to find their education system away from the Word of God. And our government-run schools are far from the Lord. And I see that on a regular basis. And, you know, it's disheartening because they're moving away, further and further away, from what the whole premise of education is meant to be, and that is to teach and train and instruct our children in the fear of the Lord. The book of Proverbs says that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom. You know, the opportunity to learn in an environment such as this is a very distinct privilege, and one that I hope none of you children, and especially not Susanna, but I hope none of you take for granted the opportunities that you've had this year to be in an environment where there are teachers who love you, who are very concerned about what you learn, about how you learn it, and about how you apply what you learn. There's no environment like the Christian school environment, and certainly appreciate the work that has been put into your lives this year. But then I also want to say that I'm thankful for the education that my children have received as they've been in school here. It's very interesting that he says, "These words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart." You know, here it's not about just math or just history or just science or just language or just music. It's about how do math and science and language and history and music, how do they apply in my life to help me to be all that God wants me to be? That's the education that is received here. That is something that any of you that have children in the school here, any of you that are considering children, having children in the school here, or that you've had children come up through Christian school, please do not take for granted the special treasure, the investment that's been made in your young people through this venue, the education that they've received. Again, how does what I learn apply to my life as God's creation? How does what I've learned in my life help me to become what God wants me to be? That's what our children are learning here. The character awards, by the way, I was really impressed. I didn't know I made the honor roll this year, but when they sang that, that mom and dad were on the honor roll, I thought, man, where's my certificate? I want one. But you know, that's something that's sorely missing in a lot of the lives of our young people today. And what our children have here, what my children have, what other children have through the education here that they've received at Calvary Christian Academy, is they have a treasure that as they move forward in life, there's memories that they've formed here, there's friends that they've made here, there are teachers here that they will not forget, and it is a unique treasure that God has given to you, an investment that these fine teachers have made in your lives, that they're hoping you'll go forward with that investment and that it will reap great dividends, not only in your life, but in your service to Almighty God. So I'm very thankful tonight to be here. I'm thankful for Susanna's graduating kindergarten, and very thankful for all the hard work that's been put into this year, both by the students and the teachers. And thank you all very much for coming tonight. Let's close in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, God, we thank you tonight for your word. We thank you, Lord God, that you have given to us the wonderful opportunity to grow in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you that you've given that opportunity to the young people who have attended this school here because they have had teachers who have invested in their lives with the thought in mind that they are going to become productive Christian people. Lord, I pray that you would help us to remember the wonderful gift that's been given to us, the memories that have been formulated here, the lessons that have been learned both in the classroom and in our everyday lives, Lord. And I pray that you would help these young people to take those lessons, Lord, and not to easily forget them, Lord, but to write them upon the tables of their heart. And as they move forward in life, Father, that they would apply those lessons in such a way that they would bring honor and glory with their lives to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for the successful graduation this evening. We thank you for Susanna and her hard work. We thank you for Mrs. Kreider and the time and labor and love that she has invested into not only Susanna, but other kindergartners before her and possibly kindergartners to come in the future, Lord. I just praise you and thank you for her investment in their lives. I thank you for all the staff here at the school and at the church. Thank you for the families who love the school, who care for the school, and who want to see your word continue to go forward in the lives of young people in this community. Father, we pray that you'd bless our time of fellowship now. We thank you for the refreshments that have been provided. We just ask that you would bless our conversation, bless our time of fellowship. May it bring honor and glory to Jesus Christ, for we ask it in his name. Amen. Ha, ha, ha.